Relationship advice. Update: my dad disowned my sister and he is dying. How do I convince her to let him go? Original post. Backstory: my family used to be really close, but that changed in 2003 when my dad, 55 male, discovered that my mom, 54 female, was having an affair with John, 54 male, my dad's childhood best friend. He was basically his brother back then, and he was my dad's best man in his wedding with mom. He begged her to stay and work things out, but my mom ended up leaving him for John, and eventually they got a divorce and my mom ended up marrying John 5 months later. My twin sister Sarah, 27 female, was always the stereotypical daddy's girl. Dad spoiled her a bit more than the rest of us and she was basically his shadow back then, and that's why it was really surprising to us that Sarah chose to stay with our mom after the divorce. Back then me, 27 male, and her were the only ones to still live with our parents. We have other four brothers. I choose to stay with dad and Sarah choose to live with mom, and in the weekends, she come to stay with me and dad. I choose to stay with dad and I occasionally went to mom's house. To say that the divorce and my sister choosing to stay with mom messed up my dad, is an understatement. He tried to act like he was okay in front of us, but every single weekday for the year following the divorce, I could hear him cry himself to sleep. After the divorce, the relationship between Sarah and dad didn't change that much. He started to spoil her a bit more than the usual and still remained the usual super dad, showing up in every parent-teacher conference, ballet recitals and soccer matches, and being the most present dad possible. Things started to change when she suddenly changed her mind about med school. Our dad is a surgeon, and she always said that she wanted to follow his steps, but mom and John ended up pressuring her to change her career path to become a lawyer. Mom and John are both lawyers. During her studies, John started mentoring her and they become really close. After she finished her education, he got her a job at his law firm. Onto the issue, in 2017 Sarah got married. My dad was absolutely thrilled about her wedding. He gave Sarah a blank check for her dream wedding. To be fair, he did this to all of us, he really liked weddings. But in Sarah's case, he was really excited because she is his only daughter and I always remembered him talking about walking her down the aisle, like every wedding that we went to. He always said to her that he couldn't wait for the day to walk down his little girl down the aisle. One day before the wedding, Sarah drops the bomb that Dad and John will be walking her down the aisle together. Well, Dad is the most non-confrontational person to walk on this earth and she expected him to just suck it up. He didn't do that. They got into a huge fight, first time I see he get angry, and in the end he didn't attend the wedding. And John ended up walking Sarah down the aisle. The fallout was massive. After the wedding, Dad and his side of our family basically disowned her, and their relationship became non-existent. She tried to reach out after a while and make amends several times, but he simply didn't want to talk or hear about her. We expected him to turn around when she gave birth in 2018, but he doesn't even want to meet her kids. Earlier this year, he was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, and unfortunately, the treatment didn't work and he is terminal. Even with that, he still doesn't want to see her again and she doesn't understand that. I am very close to my dad, and these last few weeks are being really difficult for me. How do I convince her to let him go? Now for the top advice before we read the update. There really isn't anything you can do. There is no way to make this less awkward or horrible for her. She made her choices years ago. Now she has to live, and die, with the consequences. I know you would like to make it easier, but I would just step back from this. The only statement should be, I'm sorry, Dad still doesn't want to see you. And spend all your energy on your dad. Not on a dead relationship. I would say, that by her choosing the man who took his wife and life away, to walk her down the aisle, that she was the one who chose to disown her father. She needs to live with the consequences. Absolutely. To wait a day before the wedding to drop that bomb. She knew it wasn't going to go over well. Terrible situation all around. Are people glossing over the fact the daughter took her dad's money for a dream wedding, and after it was spent then she tells him, oh by the way, that dream of you walking me down the aisle, you need to share the dream with the guy that stole your wife and split up your family. That was an absolutely scumbag move. Is what I was thinking. The dad was a walking bank account to her, and she never considered all the efforts he did for her. Yes, it's okay to change plans and decide different careers. But he spoiled her, loved her unconditionally, followed her with admiration and care, and she brings a blow like this upon the father who lost everything. She took him for granted. Daddy, thanks for paying for my dream wedding. I need to tell you one thing, I want you to walk me down the aisle with the guy that effed mommy behind your back, and then stole her away. Do you remember him? Your former best friend turned most hated enemy? Yeah, I want to give that man equal honor as father of the bride. I don't understand why you're upset, Daddy. All of this. Any idiot would know that this would cause a problem, and she had to be a cruel, spineless person to spring this on her dad, on the day of the wedding rehearsal. And now for the update. A week after I posted the original post, my dad started getting worse. His health started declining really fast. We lost him exactly 1 month ago. It wasn't pretty. I never thought it would be, but I never thought it would be that heartbreaking. He was in a lot of pain. He'd been through so much in these last months, as heartbreaking as it was for us. He deserved to rest, he was tired. In the end, he was lucid enough to say his goodbyes to me and my older brothers. Hearing him saying what he said to me was one of the most painful and beautiful moments of my life. His words to me meant a lot. I won't say exactly what he said because I believe that it's just too personal. He said goodbye to my daughters, 11-month-old and 2-year-old. It was just like when I was a kid. He gave them a kiss on the forehead, told them to be good girls, and said that he loved them. It was something I won't ever forget, and it hurts like hell that they are so young to understand what happened. They still ask about Grandpa, and every time I try to explain to them that he isn't coming back, they don't seem to understand that, and how can I blame them? I'm only 27 years old, I honestly don't get it. I was supposed to get a lot more years with my dad, it doesn't seem fair at all. The worst part was my twin sister Sarah. Dad died without speaking to her. I tried to talk to him about her, but he wasn't interested in speaking to her. She started getting more desperate and suddenly, he died. It was expected, but she was in denial. His funeral was beautiful. A lot of people shared their stories about him. It was nice. Sarah saw Dad for the first time since the night before her wedding. She didn't recognize him. He was very skinny. Dad was always a bit overweight, the famous dad bod, but he had lost a lot of weight from cancer. She cried a lot during the whole funeral. Mom and John tried to show up at the ceremony, and my uncles were forced to kick them out of the funeral. Good freaking riddance. Dad's will went as expected as it could. Dad's family came from old money, petrochemicals, so he always had a lot of money. He left a little bit of money and properties divided equally to all his kids, including Sarah. He left a trust fund, which was a lot of money, for all his grandkids, including Sarah's kids, which he never met. It was honestly expected. My dad never really cared about money that much. He just wanted us to be comfortable and assure that his grandkids all had something to support them. The tricky part was the personal things. He left a really big letter to all of us, except Sarah. It was really personal stuff. In my letter he spoke to me about our story, about my childhood. It was really nice. I must have read the letter like 100 times and I cried every single time. One of Dad's favorite hobbies was photography. He was quite an enthusiast, and the subject of his photos was pretty much our family. When he and Mom were together, later it turned out to be just me and my siblings. As a result of this, we had a lot of pictures from us growing up. He gave each of us a photo album, and behind each photo, he wrote something, where it was taken in a few words. I was honestly very surprised with this. He must have done this long before he died. It was a very thoughtful goodbye gift, something that was very typical of Dad. Sarah didn't get a letter, and her album didn't have anything written behind her photos, and when she found out about this, she had a mental breakdown. The regret was eating her alive, still is. She was admitted to a hospital and spent an entire week there. She is doing a bit better now, getting a little better every day. Her husband and I are really confident in her recovery. She is sleeping and eating almost normally now. She still starts to cry randomly multiple times on a daily basis, but it's getting better. At least that's what I am telling myself. Which brings us to last week. My wife and I discovered that we are expecting again. It wasn't planned or anything like that. My wife switched birth control last month and she spent a week without taking the pill. It's still very early in her pregnancy, so we haven't told anyone yet. The thing is, that I'm really angry. I'm angry that my future kid is not going to be able to meet Dad. I'm freaking pissed, honestly. It doesn't seem fair at all. I'm angry and I'm scared. My dad was supposed to guide me in the whole parenthood process. He was teaching me a lot of us with my daughters. I'm freaking scared of doing this without him. I'm scared of not being a good father like he was to me, because my kids deserve that. This is it, folks. This whole situation could be a lot better. I play the what if scenario on my head every day. Unfortunately, it doesn't change anything. This is honestly a bitter ending. Doesn't seem fair at all, but that's the thing about life, it's actually never fair. I want to thank everyone who gave me advice and to everyone who reached out and offered their support in the chat. I was very lonely at that time, still am, haha. F this year, honestly, it meant a lot to me. Thank you, Reddit. Now for some comments. This whole situation is sad. It really is. My condolences, man. You, Mom, and John sound like very entitled a-holes judging from what you wrote in the update. To have the audacity to show up after all they did. What exactly were they thinking? Or smoking? Anyways, I believe that Sarah will be okay, but will probably not fully recover for a long time. She needs therapy. And you and your family have to focus on your own healing at the moment. Oh, and congrats on the new baby/babies. Tell them about their grandpa one day. I read your last post. Your dad sounded like a genuinely good person who fell for the wrong kind of woman, and this tribute post by you makes me sound even better. I can only imagine how bad you feel. My condolences. Honestly, your mom and John, having the nerve to show up at his funeral after everything they did. Goddamn narcissists. It's unfortunate that your sister never got to reconcile with your dad. But that's completely on her. Choices have consequences and she made a bad choice. She'll live with this regret for the rest of her life, but hopefully she'll use the regret to become a better human being. You and your siblings seriously need to think about cutting John and your mom out of your lives. They're not good people. It's extremely sad that in the end your sister will have to live with her guilt for the rest of her life, and she couldn't even make it right with him before he passed. Honestly, I really don't know much else to say other than advise your sister to go to therapy to cope. But I don't think she'll ever forgive herself for what she did. She should feel guilty, and I am glad his dad never gave in. Now she will know the misery that he felt when she told him he was going to walk her down the aisle with John, and she will feel that for the rest of her life, which she deserves. Now for the last story. I, 37 male, have a biological child who I've never seen, 17 female, wanting to make contact, which I don't want, but my family does. What should I do here? When I was 19, I was violated by an older colleague, 34 female, after a works night out and she got pregnant. It didn't go anywhere legally, as it was my word against hers and she had the kid. Sadly, as there's no proof it wasn't consensual, I had to pay child maintenance until it was 16. Obviously, as it was a product of what happened to me, I wanted nothing to do with it. Told her to raise her unwanted baby herself. The woman died, not sorry about it, a couple of years back, and I've not heard anything about the kid since, so I had no idea what was going on other than my maintenance stopping. Which was a relief, because I finally felt like a millstone had been lifted from around my neck. Because of what happened, I never have been in relationships because of the issues it's caused me, and I haven't got any kids or anything like that, so I feel like I can start living a bit. Brought down to earth a bit last month, when my mom said the kid got in touch with her on social media, and asked about me slash my family, and told them she was living with her grandparents herself after her mom died, until they both died themselves, so she doesn't have anyone now. Now my mom is one of these people with a massive soft spot for kids slash young people, so feels sorry for her. I told her I don't feel comfortable with her being in touch with us and I want nothing to do with her, so keep her away from me. She seemed upset, but I thought she accepted it. I will say, through it all, my parents have been an absolute rock. They were some of the only people to support me, and I couldn't have done it without them. So, I was talking to my mom at the weekend, and she admitted to me that she's not only kept in touch with the kid, but she had met them the week before, and they didn't tell me. Basically, they feel really bad for her, because of the life she's had and are starting to enjoy her being in their life. Not only that, she's been asking about me and what happened, and wants to meet me to talk and ask me questions. Obviously, I'm upset about it. I not only had to go for going against my wishes, but for betraying my trust like that. She said it's hard for her and my dad because of the way I've been, never had any kids or anything, they have always been sad that they'll never have a grandchild, and this may be their only chance. She also told me she thinks I'm being out of order, taking it out on an innocent child who didn't ask for this, and could at least meet her to talk. I've said no, and not spoken since, which is hard because I normally ring my folks twice a day, and my mom keeps on trying to ring me. I don't know what to do, Reddit. I obviously don't want to be cruel, but that kid is a reminder of what happened to me, and I am just angry she's coming back into my life now when I thought it could be over. And how could my parents do this to me when they know how I feel? As it stands, I have no desire to meet her, and don't see the good that could come from it. But I don't want to lose my parents either. What should I do? Now for the top advice. I'm sorry for what you've been through all those years ago, and I'm more sorry that you've suffered all these years since. Have you ever been to therapy to help you cope with what happened to you, and begin to heal? I have, but I don't think it's really helped me so far, so I abandoned it. Go to a therapist that specifically works with trauma. It is a special training that many don't have. There are bad therapists and good therapists. Find one that works for you. There is no need to be a prisoner for the rest of your life over this. That's just how I've felt all these years, but never been able to put it into words. Thank you. I think you need to go to counseling to practice enforcing strong boundaries if you want to maintain a relationship with your family. You did not want that child, you did what you had to do by paying child support. It's sad that she lost her mom and now wants to meet you. You may be biologically related to her, but you are not her dad, and you made it clear right from the beginning. You are not the bad person here. This is just an unfortunate situation for everyone involved. Doesn't change the fact that there's an innocent 17-year-old girl with no family whatsoever. OP doesn't have to be a father figure to this child, but she's still a biological offspring of her grandparents, and it's not fair to tell them they cannot help this girl out of a terrible situation. Is it OP's responsibility? No. Would it be easier to forget she existed? Yes. Does it change the fact that she does exist? No. This situation is tragic, and it's going to cause hurt to someone, regardless of the decision made. Either OP, a 37-year-old man, can be reminded of an awful experience but still be surrounded by loved ones. Or a 17-year-old girl can be reminded of her own awful experiences losing everyone she is close with, and be surrounded by no one. I know this will be the unpopular opinion, but I feel that the 17-year-old girl's welfare takes priority. He doesn't have to be in his daughter's life, but he can't ask his parents to ignore this girl after she has reached out to them. I think it's likely the girl has no idea how she was conceived. It would make the most sense to me for your mother to tell her. If she can understand why you don't want to see her, it will help her to respect your boundaries. At the same time, as far as your parents are concerned, this is a minor blood relative that needs help, who is technically their son's child. I don't see a person who has compassion being able to turn her away. At the same time too, it's absolutely inappropriate for her to force a relationship between you two. If she persists, don't speak to her. Edit: so, I spoke to my mom today. She's still insistent on having a relationship with her. I said she can, but tell her I do not want to meet her at all, and won't do it all. Would you believe my folks are actually intending on her coming over and having Christmas dinner with us? I basically said if they do that, I'm not going. Important edit: I get people disagreeing with my parents' actions, but do not be disrespectful of them or call them names, please. Despite this, they're wonderful people and were the only people who have ever had my back throughout. Thank you. And that's it for this video, guys. If you have thoughts to share, leave a comment below. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you like this content. I'll catch you in the next one. Good day, everyone.